Hello everyone, accept greetings from Sarpan Consulting Services. Today we will show how we can do the code analysis from Eclipse. Here in Eclipse I have three projects, add-ons, OpenERP server and OpenERP web. To do the code analysis on add-ons, first of all I have to set a properties. In properties I have to set some Python path to check the imports unused variables and useless imports in Python files. In source folder, first of all I will put the self addons folder here. Then in external library I have to add resource folders, and add resource folder I will add the server and OpenERP path, and then I will do apply and OK. Once I will apply those properties, I will do the right click PyDev and do the code analysis. So once I will start the code analysis, it will compile each and every file and it will do the code analysis for all the files. And wherever I will have some errors, it will show the cross link like red marks, and if there is a warning, it will show the brown box. So here in account we can see that where is the error and where is the brown box. See this file, it says there is some error. I will open the file. If there is a warning, it will show this yellow box with the file. See this time, it means unused import times, it means the time is never used in this file but import here. See, I cannot search time field the import here. If I will go to the error page, it will say okay, undefined variable from import unlink. From OSV we are using unlink, that is undefined because in external library we didn't put OSV directory there. That's why it is showing some error. But these are all the errors with red box, with yellow box it is some warnings. Here in yellow box again we have some warning, bad indent 13 space, because we are using 4 space as a tab. So I will do this and save. Now it's okay. So using the code analysis of PyDev, we can easily trace the warnings and error and unused variables plus unused imports. So here we have unused variable X fields. So such kind of the normal errors we can easily trace using PyDev. Thanks for watching the video.